Memorial service to Shane Warne is being held at one of his favourite places, a place where his talent shone, the Melbourne Cricket Ground.
Yeah, 50,000 people are expected at the G to farewell Warne, along with a cast of famous faces, all overseen by Warne's close mate, Eddie McGuire. Eddie is at the MCG with Tash Exelby.
Good morning, guys. I'm feeling very privileged this morning because I'm about to do an interview about an Australian legend with an Australian legend
Thanks,
in the form
Tash.
Of Eddie.
We're just
How
telling
are you?
Old war stories about out in the park in the days when I was a Channel 10 reporter. So it's fantastic. TW, your cameraman, was my camera assistant in those days, and we actually grabbed the Premiership Cup in 1990 and came out here and did a live cross back in the day. So
well,
there
that
you
explains
go.
Why he's so unprofessional then.
Exactly.
If he's doing time with you.
Exactly. He was almost doing time with us because we were chased by the police that day, but anyway.
Eddie, I think, you know, you're a phenomenal broadcaster. You're very welcome. But turns out you're not a bad bowler as well. We got some video of you earlier. Yes. I'm not sure if you've got the leg spin down, Pat, but one of the things I found extraordinary about it was that I think that some of the kids that you were playing with, they might not have even been born when Shane Warne was playing. I mean, what does that say about this great man?
I look back to myself at that stage, you know, because my parents weren't from Australia, so I was the first one born here. And how did I develop a love for, well, let's have a look at this bowling action. No, it's not too bad. Yeah, smashed over mid-wicket, that's a bit normal. But, my love for the game of cricket, because it wasn't a family game and things like that. But you've got people like, you know, Sir Donald Bradman and the stories. Keith Miller was an amazing story, you know, the amazing bowler and all-rounder who was a World War II fighter pilot and, you know, was dating Princess Margaret and was the
player. So
he was the Shane Warne of his day,
yes.
You know, who played for St Kilda, by the way, and you sometimes wonder whether he was reincarnated. But, you know, those stories were the things that I grew up with, and then those heroes. So for these kids, they've seen Warne on the television hosting. They've probably seen, maybe got the tail end of him at the Melbourne Stars. But because we've got so many stories about him and all this, you can't help but find out about the mystique of this guy. And, his legend will continue because it's so big. Luckily, he did play in the television era, in a big TV era, and in almost all forms of the game. So it's not like you say, I wonder how he'd go in one day, because we know how he went. He won the World Cup for us. We know how he went in the 2020 Big Bash, because he was a superstar for the Stars, and he won the IPL for the Rajasthan Royals. So we know all about him, and obviously the rest of his life was well documented at times too, so we found out a lot about him.
That's so true. Shane Warne was certainly...
That ball just epitomises everything. You know, first ball in England up against Mike Gatting, former England captain, great batsman, and his facial expression almost summed up what it was like for the rest of the world. And then this moment for the hat-trick with Burnie taking that catch on the MCG. You know, another great moment here at the G.
Absolutely.
And of course, his 700th as well, which I was lucky enough to be at for those. And just unbelievable.
Incredible. And and speaking of which, a man who has such a highly decorated career, both as a cricketer and also what he did off the field, you are producing tonight's tribute.
Yeah.
How does one go about paying tribute to a man in just one night?
Well, you're trying to get little facets of everything. But I think, Natasha, what's been so great, and the fact that you're standing here and your show is doing crosses here today, sums it up. Everybody has said, you know what, this is something special.
Mm.
So, you know, we had Robbie Williams overnight from Switzerland sending through a special dedication, which I haven't seen yet, but my team tell me is absolutely fantastic. Elton John stopped a concert in in America.
Yeah.
And you'll see it tonight, up on the screen, shots of Shane as he explained to the Americans just what this was all about. Ed Sheeran, who played some of his best performances down at Warne's Man Cave in Brighton on the Red Wines with him and Michael Gudinski. And it's amazing to think within a year we've lost both of these wonderful people. And then you've got Chris Martin, who not only has done a performance, but he actually recorded and composed an instrumental for the funeral, which we'll use tonight as well, and then did a second version of it and has now done a third version while he's doing his world concert tour in Costa Rica. So these aren't people dialing it in. They're not saying, hey, listen, it's right. Get the film clip and just, you know, run it underneath.
Exactly.
You've got our permission. No, these are heartfelt.
Yes.
And then, you know, John Stevens, Anthony Kalea locally, and then the plethora of friends, stars, and everybody else. And then the fact that we have 50,000 and every television station involved is just wonderful. So, you know, tonight, Even if you don't follow cricket, it's going to be entertainment.
Yep.
It is a memorial, so mm-hmm. there'll be poignancy there. I mean, there's not going to be a dry eye when the kids get up to speak, I'm sure, and Keith and the likes. And, you know, it's funny, last night, right at the end, we did a sound check last night, and I've been immersed in it with the family, obviously, all the way through. And you think you're right, and then there was a photo just went up on the screen late, and it just hit me, you know, that...
Yeah.
He's not here anymore. And there's going to be moments like that tonight, I'm sure.
Yeah, it's interesting you say that, Eddie. I remember the breaking news came through at 2 a.m. Australian time that Shane Warne had died. I couldn't believe it. I spoke to many cricketers and some of his friends that day asking if they would like to do an interview, and they just said, Tash, I'm in too much pain to do that. You came here. Shane was a dear friend of yours. Yeah. Firstly, so much respect for you to have the courage to come down here and speak so openly, because it can't be easy. This was a dear friend of yours. And if you don't mind me asking, how are you doing, Eddie?
Well, Natasha, it's one of those things. In these situations, we all pull together. And, I've got an expertise in doing this. I talk for a living and hopefully can articulate the feelings of what everyone is saying. So that morning, my phone rang, and in fact it was my son who rang me. And you know, as an old football president, they're not ringing you at 1 o'clock in the morning to tell you you've won Tats Lotto, so you know that there's something not great on the other end. So it was my son's name, and I thought, oh, here we go. And thankfully he was on there. He said, Dad, there's word getting through that Warnie's dead. Well, I remember I didn't react at first. It was just numbness. And then the Northern Hemisphere friends started ringing, and then we started texting because they seemed to have more of an understanding of what was going on. Then it was confirmed to me. And then we had almost like a self-help group on a WhatsApp, and all of us, about half a dozen of us, at 3 a.m. talking to each other. And then obviously it took off, and then people started to ring. And then the family then asked if I could, you know, step up as a bit of a spokesperson for them. And I was, you know, more than happy to do so. But, yeah, you do. I actually, the last thing I did last night before I went to bed was, lying in bed before I went to sleep, was think about, you know, I'm going to get through tomorrow, but, you know, I've got to take a little bit of time at some stage to let this sink in. Not just me, but all his friends, because, you know, we've got Alan Border right next door to us.
Sure.
Andy Lee's been here this morning, Dermot Byrne. Everyone has mucked in. Everyone's got in and said, right, come on, we've got to do the right thing for Warnie. Let's dig in. But to your point, one of the top international stars in the end said to me, I can't do it just yet. I can't. He didn't want to. His heart was breaking.
Yes.
And I won't say who it was, because I don't embarrass him, because it's a wonderful person, and he will do something special later on. So he couldn't quite get to the line. As public a person and performer and superstar as he is, he just couldn't get to the line because it was still too raw. So it's how people react, in different ways.
So true, so true. One final question, Eddie. I mean, we know that you are a Collingwood fan. We know that Shane is a St Kilda man.
Yeah.
Will you be happy for St Kilda to kick a few through the sticks, or your love for Warnie doesn't run
quite
that deep?
The first game after Warnie passed, of course, Collingwood did give St Kilda a belting, so that was fantastic. And Brooke Warne is a Collingwood supporter, so there's Collingwood, the intelligent side of the family, both for Collingwood.
Mm-hmm.
But, Warnie was great. As I said, he started off as a Hawthorn supporter, Barrington for Dermot, and then fell in love with Trevor Barker and played down there, and then became a passionate St Kilda man. And he was fantastic. The 2010 grand final, you can imagine what it was like having a draw and then a second grand final between Warnie and Eric Banner and all those, Molly Meldrum, Gudinski, all those lunatics down there at St Kilda versus us, you know, sophisticated Collingwood people. We even put our teeth in that day, you know.
Well, what a treat. Eddie, I know you are incredibly busy today. You've been incredibly busy for a month. Your time is precious, and we sincerely thank you for it.
Natasha, one final thing, if I can say to you and everyone at Channel 10 and Studio 10 have been right at the forefront, but 10's Eyewitness News and my old stomping ground. The Warne family are at pains to say thank you so much for the respect that has been afforded to them, and also the genuine love, and that's why they have gone the extra yards of putting out statements today and audio and video grabs, and tonight will give of themselves. And thank you to everyone in our media community for doing the right thing. He sold a lot of papers, he got a lot of ratings over the journey for a lot of organisations, but it's truly been wonderful the last couple of weeks. I hope it continues.
Thank you so much.
Thanks,
Eddie. I'm triple vaxxed. Let's hug it out.
Yeah, good on you. There's going to be a bit of that going on tonight, I tell you what.
I think so. We'll all need it. Eddie, thank you so much for your time. Back to you guys in Sydney.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks for that, Eddie. Great work, Tash. Keep it up. Yeah.